Everyone, welcome back. I am going to finish watercoloring this day. Let me adjust some things, actually. Okay. So I've got my water. I've got my ink. I've got my phone. And I've got my reference images. Let's get started. I'm gonna look at this with my colorblindness out real quick. Let me actually looking pretty cool. So my make the roots feel yellow approach is working. And make the shadows feel blue. Yeah. So that's working. It's gonna look cool. Oh yeah, so the roots of this tree look very, like the tree bark is very, I'm gonna pull up something real quick. Okay, I guess I have to F11. Can I make it narrower? Yes. Move this over here. No. Tall. And narrow. Thank you. Ah, dang. There we go. So... reason why I just did all that is because I already have the final illustration for the second part of the, like, way to show this world off. So I'm putting it here so I can see what it looks like. Oh, it's actually... here we go. There we go. And this is actually going to work because the tree actually does feel a bit more orangey than the other trees in the illustration. The second one. Oh, let me shade this, I guess. These roots are ending up with a lot of different colors, but I think that's actually a good thing because then they'll, like, you can see them weaving in and out of each other no matter what your color vision status is. It's like, even if you can't see that many colors, you can still see color variation. Like, for example, if you're red-green colorblind, you can't really tell the difference between, like, if a gray that you're seeing is red or green, but you can tell that it's a different gray if you pay close attention. Or at least, like, that's what I've noticed when I've been doing it. Like, a lot of colors feel the same, but if you're good at what you do when you're designing it, and you're keeping that in mind, you can design around it. So even if two colors blend in together, you can still make it so that the important elements pop out against each other. And like, again, one of the main reasons why I'm doing this is because, not just because my boss is partially colorblind in a specific way, but because, like, this is a show about, you know, my whole thing is disability advocacy, and this whole show is like, you know, pay attention to your mental health. Treat people with other disabilities than you with respect. Like, so I want to keep everything in mind. Even things that you don't think of, you know. Like colorblindness. Something that I want to design around with for this one. We're also thinking of doing, like, audiobooks and stuff for this. Not a whole lot, but, you know, some. It's something we're keeping in mind. Oh, this is a banger. I chose the energetic, copyright-free stream today, like, playlist. And I'm being a little bit more careful about that, because my part 6 of this series did get copyright-stricken, and I had to, like, do the whole change the copyright thing. Like, make the music different. YouTube's editing it for me, but it's gonna take a while. Let's close this window. Take off my sweatshirt. I have an undershirt under it, but. Oh. You can see. I'm gonna do a bit of that in between purple blue now, I think. might skip this one, actually. Cool art, though. Oh, come on, YouTube. There we go. What I'm doing is I'm adding water to the watercolors so that they soften up a bit. We'll be right back. Looks kind of like an ocean in the, like he's in water. That's cool. You know, I think in a way I'm really grateful that a lot of the projects I've worked on are in black and white, because it gives you a real... Because, like, working in black and white gives you a really good sense of value and how to manipulate it to make certain elements stand out.
Staring at the stars fall. You're fading and I can do nothing.
fun too. Okay, quick tip for anyone watching. If you're doing big work like this, food is important. Give yourself fuel. Don't try to like tough it out or anything, just like eat. And that'll help you keep going to get it done. Also, caffeine isn't food. Don't just have coffee and call that breakfast. Have like, I don't know, a protein bar or a potato or something. Eat. Slow work. I love myself the most complex piece for last. Alright, BRB, you guys. I'm gonna refill my water bottle. Eat and hydrate. Important. I have about 3 little potatoes and a small bundle of green onions in my kitchen. Oh, and like quarter of a jar of peanuts. Oh, that's fun. This song is called You Can Do This. Important messages. Yeah. I'm starting to space out, so I'm gonna take a break on that grocery trip, maybe pick up a coffee. So, love you guys. See y'all later.